And then we have this, the Lexus NX300 F Sport. Now, this is the first Lexus that we're featuring on the program, so you could say that we're pretty excited about it. So, with so many crossovers out on the road, the question is the NX300 worth considering? Hey guys, you're watching REV, your ultimate guide to choosing your next ride. For this week, this is what we have for you. The Lexus NX300 F Sport. Yep, she's a looker, all right. Under here is a 2-liter turbocharged engine that gives you 235 horsepower and produces 350 newton meters of torque. But first, let's talk about how this thing looks on the outside. It is one sharp design, and I mean that quite literally because it's been designed with a lot of sharp lines and angles. Let's start off with these daytime running lights. Nice sharp L shape, which frame these attractively designed headlamps. Now take note that the headlamp, the daytime running lights, and the fog lamps are now full LED. The two-tiered front lip is also quite attractive, which brings us to the main feature of this design, this huge front grille, probably one of the most polarizing features of this car. Now, some people think that it's a little too big, and some people think it's exactly what sets this car apart from everything else out on the road. Take note that this is the F Sport model, so you've got the sportier mesh design on the grille. Over here, you've got more of these sharp lines and angles which draw the eye towards this all-important Lexus front badge. Over on the side, you'll notice the sporty profile. It's got a nice, long, sloping hood, more of those sharp folds, creases, and angles towards the side, which lead you to those attractively designed tail lamps, which look even better when they're lit up. Now, you have to hand it to Lexus for coming up with their own design language when they designed this car. It's sharp, it's angular, and quite different from the average SUV and crossover out there on the road, which nowadays tend to all look the same. Now, once you do step into the inside, you do feel very special indeed. Let's start with talking about this beautiful red and black upholstery happening here on these very sporty seats. Now, these sportier seats are actually exclusive to the F Sport range. Base models will have seats in synthetic leather, but more up-spec models will have this in genuine leather. And these are really quite nice. I really love this color combination here. Nice combo of textures, perforated leather towards the center panel. The perforation helps, obviously, because you've got the heating and cooling settings on these seats, which are really a nice touch in a hot country like ours. The steering wheel is quite compact, quite sporty. You've got the shift paddles in place for a bit more control when you want to drive the car in a bit more of a sporty way. There's some nice contrast stitching details happening across the dash and on the steering wheel, which overall to me gives the car much more of a sporty sort of vibe. It's quite a roomy car here in the front, but a little bit short on space in the back if you ask me. But then again, that's par for the course for a compact crossover like this. Now, once we start the car up, there's some nice design details that we can point to. Did you see what happened there? The steering wheel and the seat adjusted to one of the three different memory positions that you can pre-program over there. Now, once the car is started, you catch sight of the simple instrument cluster, two analog main gauges over there, and in the valley in the middle, you've got a multi-function display, which gives you information like, I don't know, your turbo boost level. It's got a G meter. You can use it as a trip meter or a speedometer and a few other functions on there. It's really quite useful and quite a bit of information on there. It's a shame that you can't see all of that information all at once. You have to toggle through and decide which one you want to view. There's also these dimmable cabin lights, which is quite a nice touch if you ask me. Very nice indeed. Also touches like lights here at the sun visor. When you open the mirror and close the mirror, the light turns on and off. Now, speaking of mirrors, you know, premium cars like this usually have little quirks, and this one has got this. I've never seen anything like this before. It's a pop-out vanity mirror to make sure that you're looking as good as your car does. Now, when you turn the car off, everything moves back to the furthest position possible so that you can have easy access getting in and out of the car. All right, Now, when you say Japanese premium or luxury vehicles, Lexus is definitely one of those brands that come top of the list. You expect it to be luxurious, you expect it to be premium, and I have to say that the NX300 certainly hasn't disappointed. We've been taking the NX300 for a few easy city miles, getting a feel for the car, and I have to say that the sportier side of Chun has certainly made itself felt. The ride is a little bit more firm than I was expecting. It's not quite as plush as I thought it would be. It's not a bad thing, but it does lean towards the sportier side of things. Basics, we've got a bit of a drizzle going on here, so we can also test the wipers, obviously. Basics, as far as visibility goes, great view out the front, great view out the sides. The body styling is has got a lot of folds and creases and angles, and you do see a little bit of that in the side view mirrors. But it's nothing to be overly concerned about. View out of the rear window is a little bit compromised. They've really committed to quite a distinct styling when it comes to the way the car has been shaped and styled on the outside. And of course, that reflects on the way that the rear window, the view from the rear window is a little bit compromised. It is a little bit small. It's not bad, but it's nothing to write home about. For the F Sport, as far as driving it in the city, it's quite nice. It's a 235 horsepower engine, gives you 315 newton meters of torque, but it's delivered in a very sort of gentle way as far as driving in the city goes. Very easy to manage, very easy to maneuver. It's quite a compact car. And the steering feel is also quite good. This is something that changes, obviously, as you drive along, and as the speed picks up, the dynamics of the steering feel also changes. You see a lot more of those sort of angular shapes here on the inside. And I quite like the way they've designed the center console here. It sort of jumps out and juts out at you, invites you to sort of play with the controls. And the switch gear buttons are quite nice. You know, they're all done up in metal. You've got textured metal over here, some nice aluminum sort of accent on the shift knob. All the driver touch points are quite nice to hold and quite nice to interact with. The buttons feel very premium. And there's quite a bit of adjustability and controls as far as those the button and switch gear that you have here. One of the standouts is this huge infotainment system that you have over here, 10.2 inches. It's largest in its class, I believe. It's a virtual movie screen that you have here. And quite a bit of information on there. The one big unusual thing that Lexus has done is they've opted for a bit of a different interface for the driver here. You control the functions of the infotainment system through a trackpad or touchpad, much like you'd have on your laptop or your desktop computer. It takes a little bit of getting used to. It's a little bit different from the usual touchscreen or a scrolling knob or button that you have in other cars. They've opted for a touchpad, which is quite sensitive, and it takes a little bit of getting used to when you want to sort of toggle through the different functions of that infotainment system. That said, it gives you quite a bit of information on there, and also same with the multi-function display that you have between the two analog dials here. It's a nice mix of analog and digital. It's quite nice to drive, quite manageable in the city. Steering feel is good. This is a good city car.